In this video, I'm going to show you how to build this weight tracker where you can track your weight progress, and this will work for both weight gain as well as weight loss, and it will also work for kilograms as well as for pounds. So the way this works is you add in the date, then you add in the actual date inside the date property, and then for the starting weight, let's say for example you're 50 kilograms, you want to get to 100, and then if you weigh 75, if that's your current weight, then the progress bar will be 50%. You'll see a triangle pointing upwards, indicating you want to gain weight. And then the same for the other way around. So let's say you're 100 kilograms, you want to get to 50. And then if your current state is 90, you are 20% done. And then 80, then you can see the progress bar is filling up. And then if we get to 50, our target weight, then you'll see that the progress bar is 100%. And also the triangle is pointing downwards. So every day, week or month, when you want to log your progress, you just add a new database entry, you add in a date, which will make it show up on the calendar view with your current weight, and then you just log your starting weight, target weight, and your current weight, which will update the progress bar. You can upload progress pictures, which will show inside of the progress picture database view, and then you can also log your body measurements, like your height, body fat, muscle mass, and then the dimensions of each of your muscle groups. So we're going to start off on a blank page, and we're going to type in /table and then create a new table view database. And this database is going to be called weight tracker. And then we're going to hide the database title and also delete the stack property. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to resize the name property. We're going to rename it to today, and we're also going to add a date property to this database. Then we're going to add three number properties. First one is going to be for the starting weight. Then we're just going to click duplicate at the bottom and then rename this one to target weight, and then duplicate it one more time and rename this one to current weight. So once you've created your three weight properties, you can go ahead and resize them, and you can also give each of your weight properties an icon. Next, we're going to add three formula properties. First one is going to be called weight percentage. The second property is going to be called weight text. And then the third property is going to be called weight progress. So before we add the formulas, let's first add some data to work with. So for the first formula, which is the weight percentage, we're going to take the current weight and then minus the target weight, which is going to be inside of brackets. And then we're going to divide this by the target weight minus the starting weight, which is also going to be inside of brackets. And then we're going to add a round function in the beginning with two open brackets, add another closing bracket at the end, and then multiply everything with 100 and also add another bracket. Once this is done, we can go ahead and click on done, and then we can get started on the weight text formula. So for the second formula, we're going to add the word weight followed by a colon and a space inside of quotation marks. Then we're going to add a plus and select the current weight option. And then depending on if you're using kilograms or pounds, you're just going to add plus and then inside of quotation marks add in kg or lb. So basically what we've done is we've just created text that shows our current weight instead of having just a number. And what you can also do is you can add all of this inside of brackets, and then at the end you can add a style function, and then inside of quotation marks you can add a b to make it bold, and you can also add in a color, so for example green, in order to make the text green. Or if you only want to do a certain part of this text, you would just remove the first bracket and then, for example, put in the bracket here, and then it will only make the 75 kilograms green and bold. Once you're happy with your weight text, click on done, and now we can move on to the weight progress. So the first part of this formula is going to be the triangle, which indicates whether or not it's weight gain or weight loss. So we're going to start off with an if function that says if the target weight is greater than the starting weight, then show an up triangle, which is just an emoji, inside of quotation marks. Otherwise, show a downwards triangle, which is again also just an emoji, inside of quotation marks. So as you can see here in the preview, it shows a triangle pointing upwards because our target weight is more than our starting weight. So before we move on to the next section, we're first going to add a variable using the let's function, and we're just going to move this closing bracket to the very end of the formula. And then for this variable, the name is going to be weight, and then we're going to add a comma, and then we're actually going to define the variable. So if we use this weight text throughout the formula, we'll be using this function that we're going to create now. So what we want is we want to use the weight percentage property, and we want to divide this by 10, and we're going to put this inside of brackets, and then we're going to add a round function in the beginning as well as an abs function at the end, and then just close it off with a bracket and add a comma. So basically what we did here is this minus 50 for the weight percentage is now minus 5 thanks to this part of the formula, and the abs function removes the minus. So now it's just 5. And then the round function just makes sure that we don't have any decimals. So the reason we need a number between 0 and 10 is to specify the amount of circles that we want to use in the progress bar. So basically what we did is instead of using minus 50, we're now using 5 so that we can have 5 solid circles in the progress bar. So once the variable is set, at the end of this formula, we're going to add a plus. And then we're going to shift enter. And then the next part of this formula is going to be an ifs function. So for this ifs function, we're going to just select the weight variable, which is the one that we just set. So instead of using this entire line of text every time, we can just use the weight variable. And then we're going to say, if the weight is greater than or equal to 10, then show the following. And then what we want to show, if the weight is greater than or equal to 10, is going to be 10 empty circles inside of quotation marks. To find these circles, you can literally just Google for symbols and then just search for a circle one, or you can use other symbols or even emojis. But for this formula, I'm just going to be using these circles. All right, so let's continue with this ifs function. If the weight is greater than or equal to 10, show 10 empty circles. Otherwise, if the weight is greater than or equal to 9, then show 9 empty circles. Circles with one solid circle. Otherwise, if the weight is greater or equal to 8, then show 2 solid circles with the rest being empty. If the weight is greater than or equal to 7, show 3 solid circles. And then you basically just continue this until the very end. So at the top, number 10 has 10 empty circles. And then at the bottom, number 1 has 1 empty circle. And then if the weight is not greater than or equal to 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, or 1, then show 10 solid circles. And as you can see here in the preview, our progress bar is now working. So if we click on done, you'll see that we now have a weight progress bar. And let's just double check if this works. So if we add 100 for the starting weight, and then for example, 60 for the target weight, and then you can see that we now have a downwards arrow. And we can now add 80, for example, and it will be 50%. All right, so the hard part is done. Now all we have to do for this view is we're going to click on the white text, hide this, click on the white percentage, hide this one as well, and then we're going to add another property, which is going to be a files and media property for our progress pictures. And then once this is done, we can go ahead and sort this view according to the date property descending. And then we can also go ahead and click on the view, click on rename, and then this one is going to be called weight. And then for this one, we're going to just give this chart icon, and then we can go ahead and create our next view. So to add a view, we're just going to click on this plus, we're going to keep it on the table view, and then we're going to rename this to body measurements, and we're going to give it an icon as well as hide the database title. Then inside of properties, we're going to hide all of our properties, except the date property and the progress picture property. So for this body measurements view, we're going to add 9 different number properties, with the first one being for your height, and then we're going to duplicate this property. And this one is going to be for our body fat, and then we're going to duplicate this one more time, and this one is going to be for our muscle mass. Now after these 3 properties, the rest is going to be for your muscle groups. So we're going to have chest, arms, waist, hips, thighs, and lastly your calves. And for this view, we're also going to sort this view according to the date property, and it's going to be descending. Now, once this view is done, we can go ahead and create another view, which will be a gallery view. And this one will be for our progress pictures. So let's go ahead and give this view an icon. Let's hide the database title. Let's change the card size to small. And then let's also change the card preview to the progress pictures property. Then the properties we're going to show for this view is going to be the date property as well as the weight text property. Now I don't have any dates or progress pictures for them, but if I go ahead and add a date, you'll see that it will show up. And if you have a progress picture, then it will also show up here. Then the last view we're going to add is going to be a calendar view. This one is going to be called calendar. We're going to give it a calendar icon, hide the database title, and then we're going to show the weight text property. And then for the finishing touch, we're just going to add a callout box, which is going to be called progress tracker. And this is a callout box set to the default background. And then for this callout box, we're just going to highlight the name, make it bold, underline it, and change the text color. And then we're just going to drag and drop our database inside, as well as give the color box an icon. And there you go. Now you have a weight tracker where you can add your progress pics, you can add your body measurements, and you can also track your weight for both weight gain and weight loss in both kilograms or pounds. Feel free to grab this weight tracker through the first link in the description, as well as my LifeOS dashboard, which already has this weight tracker inside, along with 9 other Notion templates to help you become more productive, more organized, and more focused. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.